Our PLR, we've reduced it probably by about 100 basis points again in the last 2 months, really. So we've been at it on a continuous basis. Whether in future it will continue happening or no, ultimately depends on cost of deposits, really, you know. Now, if you look at the cost of deposit today, there is a natural problem because at some point of time, your deposits start competing with your small savings interest rates, really. So I think beyond a certain amount, unless small savings rates come down, it's very difficult to reduce the interest which you offer on your savings deposit. And unless that comes down, you know, I'm sorry, on the term deposits, and unless those rates come down beyond maybe another 25 basis points, I think it's very difficult to reduce lending rates, really. On the lending side, hence, maybe another 25, 50, because you're talking about excess liquidity in the marketplace, really. Not more than that. For it to happen more than that, either the cost has to come down significantly, or there has to be a sudden drive for asset acquisition.
What is the strategy for Kotak Bank in this financial year? As in, what sectors are you keen to lend to? What are the measures that you're taking to push credit growth? And what are the sectors that you would be careful in lending to?
See, at this stage, you know, we've been reasonably pessimistic about growth, yeah, because you look at any segment of the marketplace, and maybe there may be one or two exceptions, but for those one or two exceptions, there has been very limited growth in the marketplace. And credit defaults are still very high, yeah, both on the secured side as well as on the unsecured side. So we've been very cautious in growth. In fact, in some of our product segments, we've degrown, yeah, rather than grown, really. Now, things in the last 1 month probably have changed, yeah. People are more optimistic or probably less pessimistic, really. But I think we want to wait for another month or so and see stability in the environment before we go out and say, okay, here, we are ready to lend all over again as aggressively as we were about a year, year and a half back, really. So, and it's not dependent on a sector. It's not that textiles is bad or exports is bad. It's universally bad. Maybe, as I said, one or two exceptions. I think the only exception which comes to my mind is probably passenger cars and related industries. Last 15, 20 days, we've been seeing similarly on maybe residential home purchases. Yeah, there is a positive trend on demand. But for these two, actually, there is no change.